experience. You know, I want to tell you a story. Last summer, I was able to go with my father-in-law, my family, and my mother-in-law. We all went to a place called Topeka, Kansas. We visited what remained of the old 1905 Charles Parham's Bible School. Charles Parham was a well-known Pentecostal preacher back in those days. And it said that in this very room, you can see a picture here, that in this very room that my kids and my family are standing, an early outpouring of the Holy Spirit occurred that sparked a revival across America. A woman by the name of Agnes Osman was filled with the Holy Spirit during a prayer service at that Bible college, right in that very room, as I was told. And she was filled with the Holy Spirit, and she began to speak in other tongues. And also attending this school, you might see in that picture there, a group of students. One of them in the middle, his name is Seymour, William Seymour. And God used this pastor, William Seymour, in, you might be familiar with this, a place called Azusa Street in Los Angeles. It's a revival that happened there, and it impacted many people. So William Seymour went to Los Angeles, and he began to pray and seek God's presence. And here there on Azusa Street, he began to pray. And as he began to pray, many people came to the Lord. And there, many people were impacted, and they began to start missions, and they began to go to all parts of the world to preach the gospel. And out of that revival, many prominent denominations were created, and missionaries sent all over the world, even to India, to proclaim the gospel. So here in Acts, if we come back to Acts, as many were gathered in that room back in the first century, believers prayed, and we see there the promise of the Holy Spirit baptism was fulfilled on the day of Pentecost. They were all baptized with the Holy Spirit. See, this is an eyewitness account that would set the stage for a new era, the promise of the Holy Spirit. It's an empowering gift that Jesus spoke about that is from God, and it's a promise that every believer must seek. So what is the uniqueness of the baptism of the Holy Spirit to that of the indwelling of the Holy Spirit? I'm going to explain it this way. The simplest way for me to describe the difference is, it's a difference between drinking a glass of water and taking a swim in the Atlantic Ocean. The baptism of the Holy Spirit is the additional and distinct ministry of the Holy Spirit, which is a different dimension. In other words, the other is to create a life of God inside a person at salvation. We're talking about the function of the Holy Spirit is to make you in Christ. But the baptism of the Holy Spirit is the empowerment with the gifts of the Holy Spirit and the power of God. So this will endow you, in you, the power that Jesus exercised in his ministry. So going to Luke chapter 24:49, I'm gonna talk about a few passages here, but I don't want you to get mixed up with that. I just want to focus in what I'm saying. So I'm going to, so here, 24:49 in Luke says, I'm going to send you what my Father has promised, but stay in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high. The Holy Spirit, baptized life, enables us to live victoriously in Christ. By enabling us to live a holy and consecrated life, to bring us to a new devotional attachment to Jesus, it enables us as believers to bear fruit, enables us for spiritual gifts. The Holy Spirit will give you and me the greater power for witnessing. Amen? And to give greater joy in what we do for God, in our worship, in our spiritual service, and gives us a greater burden for the lost souls and heightens our sense of missions to the world. I'm going to give you another verse, Ephesians chapter 1, 13 and 14. I'm going to paraphrase it. It says, when you believed, you are marked with the seal of the promise of the Holy Spirit. So Paul is saying that I keep asking that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that you may know him better. The eyes of your heart may be enlightened to know the hope of his calling and his great power for us who believe. So the same power, Paul is saying here, that raised Jesus from the dead and seated him in the heavenly realms, that same power, resurrecting power is in the life of the believer and enables us to have a victorious life each day in Christ. So how does a person prepare to prepare for the baptism in the Holy Spirit? The baptism in the Holy Spirit, we must understand, is a gift from God. It is a gift that we must be thankful to God for. It is not something that we can earn. It is not it is accepted with an open and willing heart. And you must confess your sins and resolve to live a righteous life with God's help. So in our worship and in our praise and in our adoration, we need to express to God, who is the baptizer, your desire to be filled with the Holy Spirit for God's glory. So as you yield to do this in your spirit and allow that power to surge and through expressions of worship and praise, right, in a language that's unknown, God will fill you and that will make it meaningful, God. So if you're seeking it earnestly, pray to God that He will surely baptize you. So tonight, I'd like to conclude by giving a couple more verses to kind of express this a little bit better and give us some examples. Luke chapter 4, verse 1 and verse 14. Dr. Luke makes mention that Jesus was full of the power of the Holy Spirit. It says, after returning from the wilderness, the Bible says that Jesus returned in the power of the Holy Spirit. And verse 18 of that same chapter, we see that Jesus stands up in the assembly, in the synagogue, and He begins to preach and teach by the power of the Holy Spirit enabling Him to do so. And He says like this in verse 18, "The Spirit of the Lord is on me because He has appointed me to proclaim the good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom to the captives and heal the blind and set the afflicted free." Today, this scripture is fulfilled before you. See, Jesus' ministry was fulfilled by the power and work of the Holy Ghost. And it is the power that enabled Jesus to complete His work on earth and to do His Father's will. So Jesus' life was victorious by the power of the Holy Spirit. And the death could not hold Him down. And He was risen and exalted by that same power. So we have that great example, dear young people, to follow, to live victoriously. And Jesus is our example. And you must lead that victorious Christian life by the power and infilling of the Holy Spirit. Zechariah 4:6 says, "It's not by power, it's not by might, but it's by my Spirit, says the Lord." So knowing this, what is your desire tonight? So God promised His believers that we would receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And at Pentecost, that promise was fulfilled. So my question to you is, are you satisfied with the race that you're running today? Do you desire a glass of water, or do you desire to take a swim in the water? Do you want to experience that daily victory in your life in Christ? Or do you want that enabling to live a consecrated life? Do you desire to have a new devotional attachment to Jesus? Do you want to experience Jesus in a real and precious way in your life? Perhaps you may say, "Look, I have a lot of friends that I want to share the gospel to, but I feel like I don't know enough to share to them. I don't have the courage." Well, the power of the Holy Ghost, the infilling of the Holy Ghost, the baptism of the Holy Ghost will enable you to have the courage to witness your faith with others. And perhaps you want to experience greater joy in what you do in your service to God today. The Bible promises that God rewards those who diligently seek Him. So you've always wanted to do something in the missions, but praying to God for a greater burden by waiting and anxiously waiting and earnestly waiting and praying for the infilling of the Holy Ghost, God will empower you to do those things. So this is your opportunity to seek the baptism of the Holy Ghost and to live a life that is victorious in Christ Jesus. So I hope that you are challenged tonight, and you might be going through